Hello and what is up, everybody? Seconds. This is a live cast just in NA
Reserve
qualifiers
time.
For the Summit 7, I believe. Is it the Summit 7? Oh, wait, I can't check because this is Summit 5. I think it's a Summit 7. Believe me, it's a Summit 7. You'll see in the title if I'm wrong or not.
Radiant's anyway, ban.
It is Elite Wolves Peruvian team. Verse is GG, Stan King's new squad here. Let's see who he has with him here today. Looks like he has CCNC probably standing in, or is he a real member? I don't know. Stan, or Snake.
10 seconds to go.
And looks like that's Francis Lee.
Dyer's ban.
As Mineski fan game. For Elite Wolves, Stinger, former Infamous player. I hate everyone. I don't know who that is. Masaku, Leo style. I recognize him.
I'm 10 seconds to go.
I hate everyone is. If I can check the profiles in the game, I might be able to figure it out better. But
Radiant's banned.
Team, regardless. Let me actually check their roster right now. I should know who their players are. Excuse us. The sound's gonna cut out a bit. Elite Wolves. So it is Kotaro Hayama, King Tekka. All right, it's King Tekka and Kotaro Hayama are the people that I don't recognize. So I'm assuming the anime
picture
is Kotaro Hayama, and then King Tekka is this dude. But enough of that.
Reserve time.
Let's check out the draft a bit here. Lifestealer first man, huh? From Elite Wolves. That hero got a hilarious new taunt, but I don't think he's that good. As he was before, to warrant a first ban like that, but I think
if
he is comfortable with that strategy, is a lot of these people have been on the team. CCNC is new, but I don't think they played together for that long, and I'm assuming they're gonna pick something that's a bit easier to execute. And Lifestealer strategy.
10 seconds to go.
Pretty easy in terms of execution. Anyway,
5 seconds.
Elite Wolves gonna pick themselves up Magnus as well as Pro Warlord. They're going for that
Radiant's pick.
RP into Troll, full team wipes, kind of like Magnus Ursa, Magnus Troll, you know. A very explosive combination. And they're gonna continue with the team fight.
10 seconds to go.
Crystal Maiden as their support. One thing to note is they did pick 2 cores right in the first phase. So IsGG did respond with Legion Commander Ricky. And
reserve time.
What they're planning so far is to just avoid Elite Wolves. Get nice vision out with Ricky, and then just try to get pick off, split push, avoid team fights. Because if they run into an RP or Trill nearby, they're as good as dead. Crystal Maiden drop her ultimate there as well. Let it go, let it go, let it go. In the second banning phase here, they ban out Lina as well as Warlock. One thing I already mentioned this, they took out both these, say, cancer heroes, healing heroes, Abaddon, Omni, and the second phase they hit Kotaro Hayama, where it hurts the most.
Dyer's pick.
Two better heroes, of course, Templar Assassin being one of his signature heroes. And they're gonna go with a pretty early Storm Spirit. Picked up as a third.
10 seconds to go.
I don't know about that. I don't think he's that great against Troll Magnus.
5 seconds.
I'm sure he can provide some extra split pushing. Is relatively hard to catch.
Reserve time.
If he gets caught, he is dead. There's no counterplay to that at this point in time. And he's not that robust of a hero.
Nice.
The Crystal Maiden route as well.
Radiant's pick.
Quite surprised to see the Storm pick come out. It is one of CCNC's better heroes, so we'll see how it works here for IsGG. A bit more about this tournament. I believe IsGG just played Fire, who they lost to 2-1.
10 seconds to go.
I'm not so sure how the format works, but
5 seconds.
Assuming they really need to win this game if they want to stay in good running for qualifying for
reserve
the
time.
Stan King is a player who's been to the Summit before with FDL as well as CCNC, and we'll see how he does with this new squad. Fire right now is looking pretty good, and it was a close series between the teams. I didn't get to watch the whole thing, but from what I was able to see, it seemed like they were somewhat evenly matched. So Let's see if CCNC can make it to another land this year. I didn't mention, but Elite Wolves did pick out the Dazzle, while IZG is taking a lot of time for this second pick in the second phase. I mean, alright, they're just thinking of support.
Dire's
they don't want to pick all their cores quite yet. I mean, because they do have, I guess, it could have done either way. They could have picked their carry here, or they could have just picked other support. It depends.
10 seconds to go.
The thing about Elite Wolves is they haven't picked their mid yet, and they have the overall last pick.
Five seconds.
Probably one of the reasons why they just didn't went for Storm here, because they're not going to be able to counter pick Elite Wolves regardless.
Reserve time.
So what are they going to pick here for Qatar Hayama now that his Ember and Templar is gone? Unless he's going to be playing troll mid, and then they pick another carry.
Radiant's ban.
Alright, they're going to ban out the Slark. Something that's relatively annoying for them to deal with. He's going to just add to that split pushing vision control, of course, with his ultimate. He's going to be able to spot out wards. And if Elite Wolves
10 can't seconds
get a good
to go.
Sure, they can farm and they can still win at any time.
5 seconds.
This is how true Warlord works, especially with Magnus. Just starting
reserve
with these
time.
First two picks is just guaranteeing that IZG
Radiant's
will need
pick.
To play the game very well. They can't afford to make too many errors, because getting caught by an RP once and not having buyback, or even then, like not having buyback on all their heroes, or maybe even losing a fight after that. We'll just need them to
10 seconds to go.
This is how expensive like troll warlord is. But
Dire's
pick. I'm gonna go with the last pick, Ursa here. Another hero that I don't think is the best. There's a lot of kiting heroes between Crystal Maiden, Dazzle, man fighting with troll. I think Ursa can do that. One of the few heroes I actually
10 seconds to go.
It really all depends whether this troll gets lucky or not.
5 seconds.
It is just a strange looking dragon.
Reserve time.
It provides a lot of pickoff potential. Ursa is a hero that can solo kill anybody, even like heroes like Dazzle, who in theory doesn't have Shallow Grave, but if he catches him off guard, can burst him down before he can get his grave off. Sometimes Storm Spirit can say the same thing for, and Legion Commander. So all three of their cores have solo pickoff potential, and they can push fairly well. Storm more so than these other two, but the thing is they have the Ricky providing
vision,
and instead Elite Wolf is gonna go with Vanguard hero with the Dragonite. He's just gonna be right in there dishing out disables, and it looks like they want to go for more team fight, team oriented strategy to not get picked off. It's tough to say who will actually come ahead, because normally split pushing strategies do come ahead of team oriented push strats and team fight drafts. Well, yeah, it's not push strats. If you split push and you're playing against a heavy split, push strat, if they can just, it depends on how fast both the teams can
10
push.
Seconds
for
to
sure,
go.
Wolves just outright to destroy towers.
5 seconds.
They gotta get on top of them. So split push is not gonna help IZG there, because every single time they try to go for a split push or trade something, they're not gonna trade. His Storm, Ursa, or Legion doesn't take a tower as fast as Elite Wolves doesn't even have to commit all their heroes. Like Dazzle, Dragonite, and Troll. Could be in a lane. Dazzle, Dragonite, just Troll, maybe someone behind them. So like four heroes, the other hero could be farming. And as long as they have a tower somewhere to TP into, they're gonna be fine with that. So you can run down towers. In that case, IZG is just going to be splitting the map and farming, because they can't really defend that well if they fall behind. So the main thing is and we'll see how they decide to play. So we start our game here. What is this? What the fuck? What am I watching right now? Look at that. Um Well, that was odd sight.
Everybody gets set.
Bought a compendium. Seems like we're just gonna be playing with default towers here. We got some Peruvian music. Oh. All right, we got some Peruvian BM there. Trying to deny his tango or share tango. He's practicing for later. He's gonna drop his full armlet. Classic Peruvian gameplay right now. I hate everyone, otherwise no one is. Right, he's still practicing. He's getting ready. He knows. He's feeling confident in this game. And I do think the Peruvians have the better draft here. Oh, what is this? That's pretty dope. That's a new addition. This music's pretty cool as well. Anyway, let's see who's playing and what. Masako on the Crystal Maiden. Vincent, which is King Tekka.
30 seconds to showtime.
I hate everyone. Is that Qatar hate? Just do a quick check here. That is confirmed, not an anime picture. So I think that's King Tekka. Carrie is gonna be played by Parayama. And Masako Stinger is gonna be on Dazzle.
The game is on.
For mid lane, they got Leo style. Here, but won't be successful. He also placed a ward down here. Scout
Radiant on one side, Dire on the other.
Continue to steal that ring away from Magnus. We actually did take a bit of harass from Ursa, but he's been able to get himself away with a nice early boots pickup. It does make him not that tanky against the harass coming out from Rulik, but I think he's prioritizing getting away from Ursa because it doesn't matter if he has poor mans against Ursa, Ursa's gonna shoot him anyway. He's gonna straight kick the stand king. This is not too common of a hero for Sanctuary to play. I haven't seen him on the video for that. I did see that, I think he was practicing it. Pugs, I guess, bring it up. And I'm assuming he's played it a bit, so. For all the players that have played it, there's a lot more Pugs. It's probably not that good. It's not one of the heroes he's played for in the past. Go back and forth here with this trade war. And I think King Tekka is actually winning it in terms of trading regen because he does have Shrine. But Stan King playing like this, he's doing a good job of keeping him. CCNC is actually piling a bunch of harass to Neo style and they get a D ward on the sentry as well, so no longer will have a sentry for this round. Pushing the wave, forcing him in a pretty bad position. So mid lane going great for CG, but usually when you pick Dragonite, you're not really expecting to win this lane over one lane. And with an addition of people going to hit it, early game is still.
Oh man, first blood just splattered!
First blood.
That was
a pretty easy kill. That's a big win for them. That was two kills against a Trilane. Snakey was already doing really good prior to that. After that first blood, he was very hard to win. And keep in mind that things kind of have to go this way for EZG's draft to work. And so they're up to a good start, but they have to keep it up.
Looks like we lost one.
Farming. Okay. He's gonna get himself away. Masako, giving up the lane now, he's gonna start jungling. His jungling will be spotted out by this ward from Ricky. Pretty smart ward placement from Flea. He's gonna be able to see when elite wolves go jungle. That's the most important thing, because that shows him when he can be aggressive and less damage. You don't see
about time.
At least one ward scouting out a ruin or blocking a camp or something like that. It is nice to see the double jungle ward. Let's see how Tekka is doing very well.
Five towers taking hits.
Really high level. Worm. CC now that Ricky is not helping him out anymore, he's gonna start to even out. So in this stage, even though it starts with a bit of a lead, the first blood onto his Ricky, bringing down Dragonite to pretty low start. He's come back and again, it just happened. Let's see. Flea, can you take this? As soon as Stinger placed it out. Nice play there. Yes, he didn't. Or LaSalle didn't tell him there was a sentry. He definitely knew before his sentry got killed, so. I knew that there was sentry in the area, but Stinger just comes in places and works and stacks. Anyone to farm up. They have no power, so. He's gonna rotate his way down to the bottom now, and he tried to get some levels and first. To go back to base. The top lane, Flea is looking to make
the last.
Can he kill him a second time? You got a bash there. They don't have any type of stun available anymore. So, that part. Snake King is still doing very well. He's just hype. This game is not hype. This music is a bit loud. I don't know how it sounds in the actual recording.
Oh, your lies!
Looks like the mid lane. Nice stun there onto Flea. He doesn't have the blink strike and Bang Knight is far too tanky. He'll get himself back to safety. He doesn't have his shrine available, so he'll have to stay around. He does have Dazzle to come in here. Dragon Blood, so it should be fine. We look at the overall net worth now, and it's still very even. Neither side having quite yet. There's a Snake King coming here onto Vincent. He's not gonna be able to kill that. I don't see any kill happening in any of these
lanes.
Someone maybe messes up somewhere. Elite heroes don't really have the heroes to make moves quite yet, but once Magnus gets one of the two more levels of Crystal Maiden, then we can see the pressure come out from them. Is GG gonna play a lot more aggressively than that? Do something on the map, but let's say that Sneaker can take Bob and harass out the farm, his ultimate stuff is still to be hard. I think they're trying to bait Snake in right now, but Elite Wolves is not taking the bait. Last hero is just standing nearby in case Vincent or Taro moves the one that gets gone on.
Still
farming very well in the mid lane right now. It's a nice stun once again. Stinger. I hit everyone, or King Tekka, I believe, will just try to get some experience in the bottom lane, but he's not doing too well in that regard. He's actually not that far behind Snake King, but Snake King has been kind of dual laning, I guess. Here, Flea plays the pretty deep ward behind the tower, and he's able to spot it out on the sentry, but immediately eats it with his quelling blade and will survive for now.
Fanbu!
The team is still farming it up. We got a bit of a resident sleeper game on our hands right now. But as I said before, both these drafts don't pick up really until the core items come out. And for his GG, I guess for Storm Spirits, he's just going to try to farm his Bloodstone. Ursa, it's a Blink Dagger from Legion, it's either Blink or Armlet, something like that. But now we're going to look towards his GG as they try to make their first move here. TP and CCNC. Snake did get that dual win. It's a mini build, but I don't know what it is. Normally you see 1-1-3, but I guess you decided to go wrong direction. So, it's one extra second to slow. Masuku definitely could have survived there.
Within your 组长将要给我的奖赏.
Kinteka farming up all of them. He's at his level 6 and he's doing pretty good in terms of.
Radiant's mid tower is coming apart.
But his farm is not that bad. It's interesting. Farming up, he's very close to his mid tower. Expect once more aggression coming out from the GG. Only heroes that can kill this thing, however, are Agnes and the Troll. I would say the Troll is the most vulnerable hero.
Radiant's mid tower is getting banged up.
There's of course Magnus, kind of hard to use here. So, while playing this slow game, I mean, it does work out for them. In terms of scaling to the late game, I believe you can scale better and can keep up the farm.
Dire's mid tower could use a little help.
Farm is fast, but with them power, they are pretty good.
The Dire went and fortified their structures. Dire's top tower is getting beat down. Dire's top tower, you know the drill.
Mar and Stan King going. Gank here on the video style. Come on with the duel as well from Snake King, and that's an easy pick off on to Leo style. They did commit a lot of that work. Vincent was just farming a big stack of entrance there that whole time. Dazzle with another kill for himself there. Looking okay right now. None of his movements.
Fong Bao Drilling, Chen
Jin!
Fong Bao!
Another
Fong Bao! Fong
Bao! Yeah, it is looking pretty good for his GG at the point, but as I said before, in terms of how Elite the Wolves drafted, he's constantly.
Radiant's toughened up their structures.
For Elite Wolves, they can just keep back and farm it up.
Radiant's mid tower could use a hand.
And how they can play the game. But anyway, they do have four heroes trying to push mid, but with the fort coming out, they no longer have a control as well.
Dire might want to die in their top tower.
Targeting the ancient stack.
Initiating killing spree mode.
CC's very low. Kind of lead the way. Leo Styles trying to hit his wreath fire, but I don't think he has the range on it, and he's not even going to kill either. So, big win for his GG there. Having the vision in this area will scout up kills. However, Elite Wolves still got the gold.
The Dire might want to mine their top tower.
I don't know if he bought out before dying, so he lost a bit of gold from there. I'm going to open the net worth, and we still see that Hariyama is pretty far in terms of net worth.
Radiant's mid tower's coming apart.
Dagger, but I think, yep, King Tekka already has it. He's gonna run into it. Now, Snake Moon's gonna have to back away. He's gonna pop it up here. We're gonna have to do it. The problem with going with Midas right now is it's gonna slow down his GG, and they want to play the most aggressive, which is like right now. They want to keep taking these fights from Sean. Now fights are gonna get a lot harder with the dagger on the
Dire's top tower's getting beat down. Dire's got one last top tower.
It's still viable right now, but the stronger the Elite Wolves gets, it's going to be a lot harder to make these types of fights. They did take the tower, so Izgg is now ahead in terms of power, as Elite Wolves did a pretty good job of taking this tower to make down low. Still haven't been able to clean up by then. That's just props out to Ruby as well as Ricky being able to slow down these pushes. And yeah, that's the max cloud build coming out from Flea. And between that and the Fade Bolt, it's very difficult to take towers at this point in time. And with both those heroes spamming it out. So I actually like these picks. Normally you don't think of Ricky as being a tower defender in this type of play, but go down. See, like, I don't know why he got caught out of here.
Radiant's mid tower's in trouble.
Very well. He's clearly at the top of net worth, and this is just a free farm and power control warlord. He's back to farm. He's looking very scary. Who's on Izgg right now? I would be a bit worried. Taking wards away from Izgg when they can. They just look at the vision. Izgg don't have that many aggressive wards or defensive wards. They actually have no wards right now on the map. And they're gonna actually smoke up zero wards. They're feeling a bit desperate right now. They are ahead in terms of kill, but right now, starting to climb up there. Instead, they're gonna walk into Roshan. Go for a gank. Three gets more here, and so they won't have to do it too late. Is GG gonna be able to get out as well? So, nice play there by IzGG. Bit of a misplay there by Elite Wolves. They should have known what was going on. But instead they played greedier, they wanted to farm this stack. And we got caught off guard. That's all from HCG going into Roshan. And so they're gonna take themselves to the first Aegis of the game. Now Tar Hayama still farming incredibly well, and he's continually
Dire's mid tower won't last much longer.
Top armor on the side. And they mentioned before that
no breaking through the Dire's structures for now. Dire's mid tower is having technical difficulties.
It's hard for the control does get on top of
Radiant's top tower is hurting. Have fun trying to bust down Radiant's structures now.
He doesn't really buy an item to go through. And then, even then, the chain back is pretty terrifying for a Storm Spirit. Especially how it's all hitting very hard. It's gonna actually jump to get really good smoke colors up to shut down this troll, but as you see, he's pulling directly into MKB. Realizes that that's the main weakness in this game, and he's gonna just go all out of this heavy invasion from the Ricky. Or the mischance, I guess we'll call it. And Stan King and your War once again going for a gank. Stan King is very fun. I mean, I guess Masako is as well, but he's playing the hard fight on the screen, and his impact in this game hasn't been the biggest. This is pretty normal. 7 roll. And now we're going to pop it to the up now.
Dire's mid tower won't last much longer.
And Francis Lee, this time trying to scout out.
Dire's mid tower is nothing now.
So it's gonna be a tower kill for his GG and.
Wrong, you don't hold back from Baldur and Chetty!
Dire's top tower. You know the drill.
The Elite Wolf is also right
here. Fortified.
And we see here that actually ACC.
Radiant's bottom tower ain't a pretty sight right now. Dire's mid tower is heaven. Radiant lost one of them bottom towers. Dire's top tower is getting beat down. Somebody iced the Dire's career. Dire's top tower's gone.
Weevil!
Well, this GG is making a very good play right now with this Aegis. They're not playing aggressively with it because that's not their strong suit. They're just playing aggressively in terms of pushing things and making things kind of objective. Elite Wolves, of course, know that they're stronger in team fights, so they're going to be more survival than two towers bottom. We look at that trade there. CCNC got a tower top. So they traded two for two towers, and they got a killer as well, into Leo style, as he was trying to back away. Now the
Dire's mid tower.
He just gets caught by that root, and if you look at Masako, he actually went out with a max frostbite. Make sure that you can
Dire's mid
have a good damage because of melt him, as we saw him go down there. So he gets a second kill there on to Stan. So is GG confident with the vision they have right here on the map? And they're gonna go down there onto Bar. They're going to make the most out of it, as it will be expiring quite shortly. After that, a couple of trades, GG gonna find a bit of a network advantage. Tarayama still significantly ahead in terms of network. Above the second closest on the side of his GG.
Oh jeez, it's a killing spree!
Nice duel onto Tarayama. He's gonna go down. Big kill there. Very big kill, actually. That's gonna allow him to take over the map a bit more, and he's not expecting that one. They were able to see the movements with these wards, and they knew exactly where he was headed, and of course he was pushing out the lane as well. So Stan King was able to call him, and he was going to go get to the wolf door.
Someone dropped out like a kid in school.
At this point in time, without the backup of his team, of course. That's one Bloodstone charge going back in CCNC's pocket. Leo style, he actually went for a solar crest onto the Dragonite. One of the more supportive models of Dragonite, and he's showing it in terms of his farm. He's not coming up there in terms of farm, and that's one problem for the Wolves. Their draft is very good, but CCG is doing a very good job of just taking over the entire map right now. And Agnes, I don't think he's even used RP once, because he just hasn't had an opportunity. Ricky Gem.
Oh, good.
And with that, they're gonna take
the Dire might want to mine the top tower.
Elite Wolves. It started out as I think Elite Wolves having a pretty good map presence with their wards, and now it's turn 180. After that biggest pickup from IsGG, they played aggressively. They got some aggressive wards off on the map. They got a couple pickoffs. Looking pretty decent now. And now they're gonna pop out the sentries. Elite Wolves gets one D ward there, but there's still two wards, one in their jungle, one.
Dire's mid tower will last much longer. The Dire weren't partial to that mid tower.
And just notice how Elite Wolves is.
Dire's bottom tower is getting the business. Radiant's top tower is in bad shape. Radiant's top tower is taking hit. Radiant lost the top tower.
They all know that it's a 5v4 if they bring all their heroes, but they're not even going to bother at this point. Scouting out another Cinder does have the dust, but I think this CCNC is just going to go for the creep cut, as well as maybe they need to pressure this tower a little bit as well. At the bottom lane, but now they realize
he is
doing a very good job with foot pushing this game right now. Elite Wolves kind of just want to run down lanes, and they're not having the opportunity to do so. By the time they get down one lane, doing a pretty good job of figuring out what's useful and not necessarily their drafts, or their draft does help. Coming out third, we don't have the ability to catch him out. Follow up that RP, and instead he went to this MP straight up. Elite Wolves still taking it easy. I wouldn't say they feel that pressure. They're looking at CCNC now and they're like, alright, that dude's kind of farmed. But we definitely can't deal with him, and we're still pretty strong with this guy, so we just have to make sure we don't get picked off and die senselessly to duels or Ursa or anything like that. And you see they are.
Here's what's happening to Dire's bottom tower. Can't do nothing about Dire's structures right now. The Dire best do something about their bottom tower. Radiant's mid tower's getting banged up. Dire's bottom tower is getting the business. The Radiant's mid tower comes to hand. Radiant's mid tower ain't doing so good. Dire's best do something about that bottom tower. Guess what's happening to Dire's bottom tower? The Dire gave up a bottom tower.
Wolves actually cut back off. Their bottom tower did end up going down to the tower there. Dragon form is still pretty healthy. It's quite easy to back off like that, but I guess they don't feel quite confident going high ground quite yet. And IsGG instead is sitting on the defensive. Now that he's
showing
himself. Oh, football! 4,000 is the actual warlord.
Spring ball! Ha ha! What a girl!
I think most of this game is not going to be on CCNC. His job in this game right now is pretty much to kill the Dazzle, or first off, kill Magnus.
What a girl!
And that's going to be harder because we don't have a gem anymore. Magnus has a Shadow Blade. Second off, kill the Dazzle.
Dire's bottom tower is getting the business.
Ideally, let's.
Radiant's top tower is in bad shape. Radiant's gone and fortified their structures. Radiant's top tower is hurting. One last top tower from the Radiant.
So IzGG went for the tower train there. One, two, three.
Here's what's happening to Dire's bottom tower. The Radiant got one last top tower.
I have to get back up to full HP there. Yeah, so the only hero that could counter initiate there was Magnus, and he didn't want to
use my own stand.
Technical difficulties.
Take a shrine and head back, it seems. I'm gonna try to take Rax from his UC. This is the most painful part. I feel like it's not the end.
Radiant's top Rax. I don't know.
It's not painful at all for his UC. He put himself in the UC. I'm not too sure that was actually worth it, but it wasn't a defense. After that buyback, Flea is never going to have an item, it seems. Say the same for Stigma and Yomara, who is already pretty far behind. You have to spend a decent amount of that as well. Compare that to the net worth change, and we do see Elite Wolf is actually coming ahead of that one. Very nice play there from Tekka's skewering that same Snake King with the Heaven's Halberd, being a bit too tanky there. As it didn't have their damage before, not quite yet. Speaking of troll, something. Flea is pushing into the bottom. Oh, what's he doing here? He's just chilling. He's gonna TP away. He did get to Elite Wolf's base. Looks like Vincent or Kotaro Hayama are gonna be building into a Daedalus. Now he's going for damage. CCNC has done a pretty good job in this game of choosing the right targets to stay focused. Now he has Jeff as well. Yes, we're playing this way. We saw it there. We got next to the Troll Warlord, and he immediately has to run away. There's no way he can touch Troll head on, especially if he's really trying on his team to get that disable onto Troll, who's low in the duel, and they also have to focus a lot of damage. That roll going on, and you saw him there. Troll is just gonna kill Vision outright. And they had a nice deep ward in their face. I think the gem was picked up by Stinger, so both teams will have a gem now. One carried by Sissy, and one carried by Magnus.
Shield! The gem
Magnus, as I mentioned before, is their most important target to go on. CNC does scan out Elite Wolves, and they're going for a jump here. Risky as they don't have anything.
He monster killed!
He
jumped down the back line. Customator was spotted out by this ward.
Zap!
One less to target him. He's up to 22 now, so he's doing pretty good. And once he gets extra armor, he's going to be able to tank this troll a lot better. Roshan will be spawning quite soon. And that's the best objective that they want to go for. Look at this GG. They are ahead in terms of kills by 10 kills, but game is still very even. Fairly good job of keeping up there in terms of farm. He is at the third top net worth of the game. Partially too, because Midas starting to kick in now. Trying to get back there. He's behind with that buyback. And his team is still feeling it after they were forced to buy back. We do have a bit of a network advantage now, but Elite Wolf is still keeping ahead on this troll. He's kind of where all their net worth is put into.
Shenyang.
He saw that hurt him there, where didn't have the damage to follow up. So they pretty much have to commit everything to try to protect the target. Somehow the dog dies without buyback and take the game over. So Isuji setting up a pretty good themselves here. He needs to focus this troll and find a way to kite him and pick off his teammates, because Troll can't 1v5. It is going to be close to his ability to 1v5 this game, especially with people. I don't think he can with all the disables that they have. The damage to burst them as well. It's still going to be a hard kill, nonetheless. Looks like CCC found himself a region when they pushed down the top lane. Both teams know that Roshan is
Dire's top tower, you know the drill.
Looks like Tara Hiyama actually doesn't have buyback, so
Dire's top tower is getting beat down.
Elite Wolves here, which could be his GG's play to win the game. CCC does have the cheapest guard now, and he's still pretty far. CCC and Snaking are looking at setup. Might try to go for one of these supports from Oscar, Hockey, and Ida. Pick off onto Ricky, who's standing on the sentry as well as an observer. And so instead, IsGG, the rest of their heroes, is gonna back
off. Top tower. You know the drill.
Did not have a TPS, but he's gonna have two.
Radiant's mid tower is getting banged up.
Not go for this trade.
Don't break down the Radiant structures like this. The Dire might want to find.
Coming out to keep him alive, but now he's gonna be back to hold you. No, Knight is coming out from the stand king. can't heal, can't heal, and
he's dominating!
My back is CNC working out, and he's gonna jump for another kill there onto Stinger. Big play from both sides, but I do think that will come ahead. Now HGG is kind of pressured. CNC can't die again. You're gonna get Roshan. It's not too smart of a play to do that at this point, so we're gonna have to move Roshan away. CNC will have that backhand on him. But if you saw there, even with the miss part, he can't follow that. They had to commit every last bit of their disables there to try to kill the troll warlord.
Guess what's happening?
The troll easily could have just manned up and killed everybody after that grave came out. But very nice play.
Dire's mid tower won't last much longer. Them dire builds are tough as nails.
Back from Kotaro Hayama. Sand King gonna go down. Magnus will not get his RP up. He's still on caps on me. Chester is still on cooldown. So they're gonna force his GG back. They don't want to take any damage to the structure. The structure is gonna phase. He did lose their team. Back away from the jungle a bit there. The dragon form committed. I feel like his GG have. Wait for the dragon form to end, and they get to the center line as well as that was picked up by Yuar. A shrine for themselves, and they're going to push in through this bottom lane, it seems. The creep wave is pushed out a bit, so we have to go back around and deal with it. And actually, they're just going to farm it out. The dragon form is looking like both teams gonna reset. Is GG sitting in their base right now? Really, they need to play right now when the dragon form is still on cooldown for another 40 seconds or so. CCNC now, so he's gonna have to fight through the evasion. So I said we're pushing the bottom lane a bit, but they're not gonna commit to high ground push. Smart to do so right now is Troll Warlord doesn't have buyback, he will just buy out for a Daedalus because of that. Six lobby right now. Dragonite's still pretty far behind, he's actually going into a Bloodthorn. Looks like he was trying to clear it because he doesn't have a BKB and actually bought out for a Bloodthorn. And so the Orchid is going to be up onto Leosal, and a lot of teams, a lot of players just buying out. So this means that this next fight could just determine the game. Tarayama pushing the control. Aegis is up for 2 minutes or something? 3 minutes? Looks like his GG is gearing up for the fire. Did the video style on how to get his dragon form online again, but if they can get a pickoff here onto Kotaro Hayama! Big jump break needs to come out, he does come out, but he can longer get the kill. Oh no, this is disastrous. Aegis to rely on now. Magnus stumped. A lot of trouble. CCNC doesn't have the gem, so Kinteka get himself away. Will get himself away, but this is definitely a setback for his GG, and I'm not so sure what else they're gonna get out of it. I actually don't think they can throw because they don't have
ain't
that
looking
damage.
Good for the Dire's so, with their
racks. Maybe if they go straight.
Dire's mid racks ain't doing so hot. Dire's mid racks ain't around no more. Dire's lost the top tower. Dire's mid racks
ain't doing so hot. What is this? It's a bit of a
Dire's bottom tower got broken, Leah. Dire's bottom rags ain't in a happy place. Fond farewell, Dire's radiant
barrel. Very hot in this game, but... not gonna call it GG yet, but... it's pretty much...
Dire won partial of that mid tower. Dire's mid tower.
I guess they just outplayed Elite Wolves. I mean, that's actually just what happened. Elite Wolves were just chilling. I did mention that whoever won the next fight would just win the game. It just so happened with Aegis onto CC&C, it was expiring like a minute or so. So they just went, they found the best hero they could possibly find, and they killed them. Grave came out from the Dazzle, but it didn't matter. He didn't have his... Satanic available to heal himself up, so he's already used it. He was like wasted with a disabler. I don't even know what happened there.
Alright, carry on.
At the end of the day, IsGG will come ahead and take this game against Elite Wolves. Impressive play by them, I gotta say. But I think Elite Wolves could have done a lot of things differently. They farmed very well, but you look at Magnus' impact in this game, he didn't find the big RPs at all. And then, as a result, they got too reliant on their troll, and as soon as the team started falling apart, troll really couldn't wipe everybody. And I gotta give it out to CC&C, he played a pretty good game. So that's gonna be it for game one between IsGG and Elite Wolf. See you guys for the next one.